Hello and welcome to this week's Scriptcase project video. My name is Jamie and I am your host today. This week I have a very special project for you guys and gals, and we have something that has been created over by Eli as well as some of the Henrique, I believe it was, from NetMake, i.e. from Scriptcase, from the Scriptcase team. And they have put together a little script for something that has been wanted. Okay, so I'm going to show you what it's all about. And of course, from there, we can go ahead and, well, you will see. Okay, so I'm going to just go ahead and run here the first application I have, and this is an image application. And I'm not going to go through all the typical processes and everything of creating the application or adding libraries or anything like that. Well, I'll go through the creation of this form for you guys within this project, of course, just so you can see how simple it was to put together. Okay, and of course, that I say it's simple, but only because of the script that Eli and Henrique have created for this project, which I tell you is pretty awesome. Now, I did make my own little adjustment, but I'm not sure it's making any difference, but we'll see. Okay, so with this, I have two image fields, as you see within this form application. Here I have a data type, which is the image database. And then I have the data type image file name. Okay, so you can apply this script to any of the data type fields for images or photos or whatever. These are essentially stored images either within the database or on the server. Okay, so with that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to drag a couple images here, and you'll see I have some of those prepared here. So if I just drag this down a little bit here, you'll see here that I have a few images here which I have just downloaded. And like, let me see the size of these. The first one is 416k. actually, I should be able to drag that into here, the window, and we can do like so. Look, so this first image is 416k. Okay, the second image is 1.6 meg, and these are identical images. Okay, so the peacock is a large image, and then the other one is 416k. It's not massive, but I think you will get the idea. So if I come here now, I'm going to drag the peacock into the first one, as well as then the second image. Now, it may not be the best thing to do because I'm using the same image in both fields. I haven't actually tested that, so maybe it's better. I was actually testing a separate image in each field. But if I just go with that one first of all, if I go add, we'll see that the record has been inserted. So now this image has been stored on the database as well as on the server. Okay, so if I now come here to my server directory, which this is locally, okay, so I am running this locally now, and it's pretty much the same way as if you have this online. If you have this online, you will have your application within now the Scriptcase folder. Okay, so this would essentially be the lib folder that you have within your project. Okay, and within this we have here the file. So there within the lib folder you will have your file folder. And there you have also the image folder, which is where all of your images are essentially uploaded. And if I view this extra large icons, we can see that is the same icon there. And we see here the size difference is now 34.6K. And again, just a reminder there, the original was 1.60 meg. Okay, so that is essentially resizing this image. So if I open the image, we'll see that it's right now it is a small image. Okay, so that's what it is opened from the server. And if I open it here from the files, we'll see that it is actually, in fact, a much larger image. Okay, so the image has been resized. So that's a nice script there that we can add onto this form. Now, what I did also, just as an extra there, is add not only the standard image resize, but then also add compression to the image. So we can reduce the size of the image even further. But in this test that I made a few moments ago, it didn't really make that much of a difference because Well, the image is tiny already. Okay, so in those massive images, it may make a big difference. And at the same time, depending on the size that you decide to store, because you can also adjust that within the script. And I will show you that as we continue on within this Scriptcase training. So keep watching. And of course, when we come back, we will be checking out the database and how you can create this application. So welcome back to this Scriptcase video. In today's video, I am showing you this new script or script that has been created that you can add to your own projects, which will then essentially resize the images that are stored in the database as well as on the server, of course, saving a ton of space. Okay, so to create this application, we just simply create a new application, which would of course be a form. And in this case, I'm going to assign it to the images table. And from there, we can see that within the images form, as well as the database table, we only have three fields. So it's kept very simple and straightforward and basic. So it's only about the ID, don't care. And then the photo and image, okay? Because for the photo, we are storing the image which we are uploading in the database. And then for the image field, we are storing it as a text field, okay? So essentially we are uploading an image to the database for this option. So if I click on create, it will create a new form for me. And there we have now form images. And as we see now, we have our field here, as well as our image field. It's not fully configured yet. So I'm just gonna jump into the application very quickly, come here to edit fields. I can hide the ID if I wanted to, just drag it down there. But in this case, I just really wanna change here the field to file image or file name and save that. And then come here to fields, come here to image. And then here I want to add a clickable upload area. Now I could add extensions here and limit the file size and so forth. And of course I can apply all of those there as well as change the height and width of the display image and more. Okay, so for the photo, I will add here just the clickable upload area also. So if I run now, I will now have an image upload field for both of these fields. Now, if I go ahead and upload the image now, it will be a very standard setup. Okay, so what I need to do is then come here into my events, and then here on script init, I need to add here, first of all, the event that I have, which then of course loads up our external library, as well as captures the event that is happening here for the image upload. Okay, so that's what's happening here. We're checking if the Ajax or refresh widget, or if there's any of these requests that are happening for the application. And when that happens, then we are going to apply here our script, which then essentially resizes the image. Now, just below here, we have our document ready function, and here we define the field names. So we have photo and image. And then we have here the photo or image size. So that right now is defined at 300 pixels. So that is why it is 300 by 300. And we could, of course, adjust this to say 800. So I'll do that now. And then maybe I'll see a difference with the compression script. Who knows? Let's see. So if I save that now, we have here our library. So I need to add this also. So I'll save that. And then if I come here to my external libraries, and scroll down, I have here a library that I've created and added to the project. And then in here, we have the script from Eli and Henrico that they made. And here the image resize.js. And this then essentially resizes the image. Okay, so I'm going to go through that in a moment. And for now, that is already there. And if I close that one, here we have then also an updated version of that script with compression of that image. So you can try them both out. The compression ratio is adjusted here. There you can define the 0.8 quality or 0.6 or straight one, however you like. And that will then also not only resize the image, but then compress the image. Okay, so I'll save that. They are already there, and of course you just need to copy those scripts into your own applications and then trigger the form by loading it within your on script init event. Okay, so let's have a deeper look at this script so we can understand a little more what is happening. So we have at the top here these requests and parameters set. So if any of these exist, as we have here, then we will load specific events. And there we have the if statement for these. Okay, so if any of these requests have happened for this application, i.e. you've uploaded a file or saved the file, then we will load here the image resize.js. And then below that, again, we have our document ready. So we define here our field variables. And then below that here, we have our handle resize, which then applies here the save functionality. Now, if I come here to the external libraries and here the image resize again, we have here the intercept field function. So that intercepts our field. The name says it all, really. And then we have some field variables defined here, which we are capturing then here. So we have the original script case ID defined here. And then we are attaching the field names, which we've defined here within our form images. So remember, that is right here. Okay, so that is there where we are defining those field names. And that is then capturing those. Now, it then checks if it's an image, and if it is, then we apply a size difference. So we adjust the size of the image, okay? This is then where the image is converted to a JPEG, okay? And of course, we are then storing that on the server. And at the bottom here, we have our data URL to blob. So we're converting the image as well to an extent and resizing then the image. We have here our handle resize function also, and that then manages here our file path as well as the AJAX event that occurs. Okay, so within those, we then manage that file or grab that file and then resize it and then store it on the server where it needs to be saved. Okay, so with that script attached to your form, whichever form that may be, whether that is a control form or the complete script case form, you would then be able to resize your images. Now, if you want to use the compression option, which is also available here within the external libraries, and that is this one here, image resize compression. And here, the compression is then adjusted down here. And that is then managed there for that. So if you want to apply here the image resize compress, you just need to adjust here the name, add the compress option to that, run the form also. And then of course, now if I go ahead and add a new image again, and this time I will take the copies that I have there. So let me grab those and take here the tiger, here we go. Right, I'll save those and add. And those are then also saved on the server. And if you remember, they were 416K. And if I come then here to my files, that has then been uploaded to the server and stored in the image location. And as you see here, that is now 95K. Okay, so let me do that then also here with the peacock image. Let's place there then the copy, and down here also the copy, and add that. And then again, we can check here in our folder. And now we have here the copy, and that's 217K versus 34.6. But remember, we actually increased the size of that from 300 to 800. So that is already a big difference from the original 1.6. And that then should also include some very light compression. Now, of course, you can increase that compression further if you wanted to. And I would say there's no problem with going to 50-60%, and they will still have a good quality for basic images that you want within your platform. Okay, so I hope that is something that helps many of you, and the project will be available for you so that you can go ahead and copy the script and integrate it also into your own projects. And remember, all you need to do is adjust here the field names and attach then also the external library or include them within the current or existing external library that you already have within your project. Okay, so that is all for this week. Thank you very much for watching. Again, my name is Jamie, and you'll find more of me over at Scriptcase by Jamie, where I create more content on Scriptcase, of course. So check it out. And otherwise, there is a load more content here at Scriptcase, where you can learn more, as well as download projects, which you can use within your own projects and platforms that you develop. So thank you very much for watching. And until the next video.